गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू इकरा इंग्लिश स्कूल। आई होप यू ऑल मस्ट बी फाइन डियर। यू नो दैट दिस इज योर क्लास थर्ड एनसीईआरटी ईवीएस बुक लुकिंग अराउंड, एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू रीड द लास्ट चैप्टर ऑफ द बुक, चैप्टर नंबर 24, द वेब ऑफ लाइफ। सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, यू मस्ट हैव नोन दैट द वेब मीन्स द स्पाइडर्स कॉब वेब, बट हियर इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल रीड अबाउट द web of life, because everything in the world is connected to each other and our life is also connected with them. So dear students, now we have finished all the chapters and this is the last chapter of the book. So in the last chapters we have learned about the animals who live on land, who live on trees, who live in water, about their ears, about their legs. We have learned many things about the animals. After that we have learned about the plant fairy, that each and every plant, and I can say that there are so many different plants and flowers, their colors, their size are different. Then in the next chapter we have learned about the water, the importance of water, because the water is so much important to us that we cannot live without water. In the next chapter we have learned about the relationships. In the next chapter we have learned about the vehicles that move on two wheels, that move on three wheels, that move on six wheels, that moves on four wheels, and there are so many different things that we have learned about vehicles. After that we have learned about the houses. Then we have learned about the different types of foods. We have learned about the pots that are made. Some pots are made by the potter, some pots are different, some are made of iron, some are made of stone, some pots are made of copper, some pots are made of wood, some pots are made of aluminium, some pots are made of bronze. So there are so many metals are there from which the pots are made. Then we have learned about the directions, the left and right. Now this is the and after that we have learned about the clothes too. Before this chapter, in chapter number 23 we have learned about the clothes. Now this is, in this chapter first of all we will read about the objectives. At the end of the lesson you will be able to identify the various animals' habitat. You will identify the ultimate source of energy, explain how energy is transferred between organisms. You will learn construct a food chain and food web, learn how all living things in an ecosystem are interconnected. So I want to make you understand, just imagine this is the introduction of the chapter. Just imagine that some students are there who have gone on a nature's walk from their school. So when they went to a park, or you can say when they went anywhere where there are so many plants and animals, then they saw that some animals are eating the leaves. As you are watching here, the animals are eating the leaves. Some animals here, the peacock, a group of peacock and pigeons, they are eating the insects. Then the students were very curious to know that how the animals and plants are interconnected to each other. How many types of animals are there? So first of all we will know about the habitat of the animals. So the terrestrial animals, they live on land. The arboreal animals live on trees. The aquatic animals live in water. The amphibians can live in water and on land both, and the nocturnal animals, they active during night, such as this is a bat.